Maybe you came across this video because you wanted to interface a USB keyboard with a microcontroller in one of your projects. In fact, it's easier than you might think. I have here a common USB keyboard and an Arduino. I will show you how to connect them now. Let's dive right into it. I would like to point out that the USB protocol is very complicated. Maybe this is why there is no USB library for the Arduino. At least I couldn't find one. A solution could be to use the Arduino Duo or a USB host shield though, but it can be done much easier. Perhaps you know these adapters which allow to connect USB keyboards and mice to legacy PS2 ports. There is no electronic inside, the signals are passed right through. Does a USB keyboard probably support the good old PS2 protocol? Let's find out. For this, I made a breadboard adapter for the keyboard by cutting a USB extension cable apart and stripping the strands. I stuff the red and the black one into the power rail of a breadboard, and the two other strands I connect to plus with two 10K resistors. This enables the keyboard. And finally, my USB scope. I press a key on the keyboard, and there we are. We get a clock signal and the data itself. Basically, PS2 resembles a UART protocol by having a start bit, 8 data bits, 1 parity bit, and a stop bit. This means that everything a microcontroller has to do is to sample the data signal whenever the clock signal is low. Let's now add an Arduino Nano and write a simple keyboard routine for this. In the setup function, I initialize the pins for clock and data. Let's say pin 6 is for clock and pin 7 is for data. Then in the loop function we need a variable that will hold the received data. Then comes a for loop in which I wait for the clock to go low. When the clock is low, the next data bit is available and I set it at its position in the variable. Then comes another while that waits for the clock to go high again. This will be repeated 11 times until all the 8 data bits have gone into the scanval variable. After that, I shift the data bits one to the right to remove the start bit. Then I mask out the stop bit and the parity, because for the sake of simplicity, we need no parity check here. Finally, it's sent to the serial monitor as hexadecimal value. There we get three numbers whenever we press a key. The first one is the scan code. This is sent when I press a key. When I release it, F0 followed by the same scan code is sent. The scan codes seem to be assigned to the keys completely randomly. At least I can see no relationship between a scan code and a certain key. What we need to do now is to convert scan codes to ASCII values. This can simply be done by an array. The ASCII characters are in the positions corresponding to the scan codes. Here you can make adaptations to the keyboard layout. For a German keyboard, you can, for example, simply swap the Y with the Z. Then we can use the scan code as index and immediately get the corresponding ASCII value. But we still get every typed character twice. The reason is that the scan code is sent again after the key has been released. So we need to make sure that we only print out the first character. To do this, I save the last scanned value and only print the character if it is not F0. I want to show you what I typed on an LCD display instead of this boring serial monitor. Additionally, I like to let an LED blink. As it is now, the LED only blinks when I type. And on the other hand, several keys I pressed are not being recognized. This is because the blink routine cannot be executed while the keyboard routine is waiting for the clock signal, and the keyboard cannot be scanned while the program is busy with these delays between the digital writes. The solution is to put the keyboard routine into an interrupt handler, which is called whenever a level change on the clock pin happens. The microcontroller then interrupts the running program, scans the keyboard, and as soon as it has collected all the data bits, returns to the main loop. Before we leave the interrupt routine, we need to clear the interrupt flag. Otherwise, the pending interrupt from the last clock cycle would call the routine again. But as there is no more data coming, it would get stuck in the first while and never return to the main loop. Now we can type what we want and the LED keeps blinking. By the way, if you find this video helpful or interesting, please give it a thumbs up. Also consider to hit the subscribe button and ring the bell, so you will never miss any of my upcoming videos. Thanks. Of course, this tiny example only supports lowercase letters and numbers. But for a microcontroller project, you will only need a subset of the available keys in most cases, and you can easily adapt it to your needs. And there is already a complete PS2 library available from the Arduino website. This works on the same principle and also not explicitly stated for USB keyboards as well. Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching. See you next time.